I'm Sharon Maclis at IDG Communications, here with Do More with R, Episode 24, Reshape Data with TidyR's New Pivot Functions. I covered TidyR back in Episode 12, but some changes are coming. Instead of the old gather and spread functions, you'll be encouraged to use more intuitive pivot underscore longer and pivot underscore wider functions. Fortunately, TidyR author Hadley Wickham said on Twitter that gather and spread won't be deprecated, so your older code using them will still work in the future. But gather and spread won't be maintained anymore, and he'll try to move users to the pivot options. First, just a very brief review of wide and long. Here's an example of a wide data set. It has multiple data points in a single row, and some important information, the time period, in column names instead of the data frame itself. And here's what a long, tidy data set with one measure per row might look like. The metro area, the year, and a single measure, the price index. So how to go from that first wide data set to a long one? Instead of gather, the new way will be pivot underscore longer. The new function is currently available in the development version of TidyR on GitHub in the tidyverse/tidyr repository. You can install it with packages like Remotes or Pacman. Here I used Remotes install GitHub. I won't run the install since it's already on my system, but I will load the package. Next, I'll import the wide data from my spreadsheet into R with Rio. And you can see the data set here. Pivot Longer uses this format. It has four arguments: the data frame, calls, which are the columns you want to pivot to become one new column, names underscore two, the name you want for the new category column, and values underscore two, the name you want for the new value column. What's really handy is that the calls argument can use the same type of column selection syntax as dplyr select statements do. You can name each column in the argument, but you don't have to. Here, I use a usual vector of column names, but without quotation marks around them. If I don't specify names for the category and value columns, they'll default to name and value. And here's that long data set. But I could also write this statement using a dplyr-like select statement for all columns starting with Q or starts underscore with. You see here starts underscore with and the character Q. If I run that, I'll get the same data set. And here's the same code, but specifying the names for my new columns. And you see they've got now the names of year and price index. To turn long data into more human readable wide data, use the pivot underscore wider function. And it's got this syntax. First argument is your data frame. ID underscore calls are all the columns you don't want to pivot. That defaults to everything you don't specify in the other two arguments. Names underscore from is the column you want to pivot, so each value is a new column. Values underscore from is the column where the values should come from. We'll run this. And there's the new wide data set. Be careful here. You need to explicitly state that the second argument is names underscore from, and the third argument is values underscore from, and not part of that expected second argument of ID underscore calls. And that's all there is to it. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the Do More with R page at https://go.infoworld.com/morewithr, all lowercase except for the R. You can also find the Do More with R playlist on the IDG Tech Talk YouTube channel. Hope to see you next episode.